Welcome to another episode of Tide Master. We're going to be doing a show on sea duck hunting. It's Black Friday, right after Thanksgiving. Let's see what we can do. Actually like a 2¾ inch with a pump shotgun more because the shells don't jam up in action quite as much. Semi-auto you can get away with 3 inch without any jamming, but this old 12 gauge you're cycling through more than one round kind of has a tendency of jamming up. These are just Remington, you know, size number 2, 12 gauge, 3.5 inch. You know, 3 inch works just fine. It's a white wing scoter right there. Here's another surf scoter. And Harlequin, I think. There's a lot of ducks out here. Set in just one string of decoy we've seen. I don't know how many duck, probably 50, moved quite a bit through here. We came in here almost at peak high tide. When you're set up on the end of this an area like this where we have a point coming out, then on the other side is the main land. We have a big channel. Then the next mainland is on the other side over there, so an island next to another island. That's where we're hunting today. And missed. I was trying to not shoot the head there, so probably shot way behind him. November came in this year. It's been one gale after another gale. It's been pretty tough to even get out this far.
Pay attention.
It's the temperature today about 30. It's above freezing, I know that. So it's good to have another, like an actual heat source with you too if you do fall in. And it's cold this time of year too, so hypothermia is a real thing. And if you get stuck out here, you never know how long it's going to take for somebody to come get you. It could be minutes, it could be a whole day. It's nice, good to have some kind of a heat source with.
There. Can you feel it?
Oh yeah. Having a campfire right on your boat. Yeah. Sea duck hunting is so sporadic. I think it has more to do with what the tide's doing than anything on the coast here. Because they feed on all the different subsurface creatures and all the critters that are around the rocks and barnacles and stuff like that. So coming out here on a absolute high tide, probably better than the other end of the spectrum on a low tide. What I've noticed is it's usually better right before the peak of the high tide, or like on the other side of the outgoing tide. Things kind of move around a little bit more. Got the heater going now.
Chips in your beard.
Huh? Yeah, chips in your beard. Thanks for telling me. Captain Chip Beard. Happens.